Hello, and welcome to today's webinar with the winner of the 2015 Young Investigator Award on analysis of solute protein binding in solution by ultrafast affinity extraction and affinity microcolumns, brought to you by Bioanalysis Zone. My name is Bethany Small, and I will be your host for today's event. I am a commissioning editor for Future Science Group, publisher of the journal Bioanalysis. We are joined today by Kelly Doring from Waters Corporation, who have sponsored the award for the last 5 years. Kelly will now provide some information on the award and introduce this year's winner.
Thank you, Bethany. We're very pleased to have Emmy Zhang from the University of Nebraska-Lincoln presenting for us today. Emmy is the winner of the 2015 Young Investigator Award. Emmy received her bachelor's degree in chemistry from Jilin University in China in 2010 and her doctorate degree in analytical chemistry from Dr. Hayes's group at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln in 2015. She's currently a postdoctoral fellow in the Hayes group at the UNL. Her research has focused on the study of drug or hormone protein interactions by using high-performance affinity chromatography, or HPAC. She has developed novel methods based on HPAC to rapidly and efficiently measure the equilibrium constants and rate constants for drug-protein interactions. By using HPAC as part of a multidimensional system, she's also been able to measure the free fractions of drugs and hormones in complex samples such as serum or those that contain several forms of a drug or more than one binding protein. Emmy has published 19 scientific papers and reviews, 8 of which have her as the first author. She has won several awards for her work, including the Best Poster Award at the 2012 FACSS meeting, the 2015 Alumni Graduate Research Assistant Award from the UNL Chemistry Department, and now the 2015 Bioanalysis Young Investigator Award. As the sponsor of the Young Investigator Award, we at Waters were thrilled to see so many well-qualified and deserving nominees. But even with such stiff competition, Emmy really stood out, and this was fully demonstrated when she presented her work at the European Bioanalysis Forum just a few weeks ago in Barcelona. We look forward to her continued contributions in the coming years. I also want to thank Bioanalysis Zone and Future Science for their exceptional dedication to the field of bioanalysis and their commitment to recognize the bright new minds in the community. Waters will continue to nurture this partnership as we move into 2016.
Thank you very much, Kelly, for the introduction. I'm Xiwen Nizheng, a postdoc at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. It is a great honor for me to be selected as the winner of 2015 Bioanalysis Zone's Young Investigator Award. I'm also very glad to attend this webinar today to share part of my research during my PhD studies at UNL. The topic of my presentation is analysis of solute protein binding in solution by ultrafast affinity extraction and affinity microcolumns. The solute protein interaction can be an important process when the solute circulates in our body. For example, the binding of drugs with transport proteins in the blood can provide important information to determine the absorption, distribution, metabolism, and excretion of drugs in the body. Therefore, there is a critical need to develop novel analytical methods that can be used to examine these interactions and to quickly provide information on the free drug fractions in the circulation, as well as on the binding constants and rate constants that characterize these drug-protein interactions. Various methods have been used for this type of studies. In the free fraction analysis and thermodynamic studies, the commonly used methods are ultrafiltration and equilibrium dialysis. However, these methods need large sample volumes and have long analysis times. Recently, an alternative HPAC method based on ultrafast affinity extraction has been developed for the measurement of free drug fraction in solution phase, but it couldn't be used to study the kinetic process of the biological interaction. The analytical methods for kinetic studies of biological interactions include stop flow methods, surface plasma resonance, and capillary electrophoresis. affinity chromatography has also been used in the kinetic studies, but all the developed methods based on HPAC technique as well as SPR actually examine solid phase interaction and mainly focus on the interaction between injected analyte with the immobilized ligand. In addition, separate methods are often used to characterize the rate and strength of these interactions. This means there is a need for new approaches that can provide all this information in a single experiment and that can directly study solution phase interactions with short analysis times and the need for only small amounts of samples. In our work, we developed such an approach based on high-performance affinity chromatography, or HPAC. This method is based on the selective and reversible interactions that can be found in many biological systems, such as those between drugs and serum proteins. In this project, we used human serum albumin, or HSA, as the stationary phase. This is the most abundant protein in serum. This protein can transport by interacting with many small molecules in the blood, including various drugs and low-mass hormones. We used an HPAC method known as ultrafast affinity extraction for our work. In this method, a drug protein mixture is injected onto a small affinity column, which in this case contains immobilized HSA. The free drug fraction in the mixture is extracted away from the protein bond form by the column in a few seconds or less, and is later measured as this fraction eludes from the column. Here are some typical chromatograms obtained in a drug protein interaction study. We can see that a non-retained peak was obtained due to the excess protein and drug protein complex. A retained peak was observed later due to the free drug fraction. Each injection can be accomplished within a couple minutes or even a couple seconds, and only 1 microliter sample was needed for each sample injection in this study. We also found the injection flow rate can affect the measured free drug fraction. For example, the apparent free drug fraction decreases with an increase in the flow rate and finally approaches to a constant value. This is caused by the dissociation of drug from its protein bond complex when the sample passes through the column. By measuring the free drug fraction at various injection flow rates, it is possible to determine both the extent and rate of drug protein interaction that is occurring in the solution phase of the sample. So the injection flow rate can determine the time of the original sample has to pass through the column and for the free drug fraction to be extracted. At low to medium flow rates, the drug protein mixture will pass through the column in a long period of time. A positive error in the free fraction will be obtained due to the dissociation of the drug protein complex in the sample. So we developed a model as shown here to analyze this data, which make it possible to obtain the dissociation rate constant for the drug protein system from the slope of the best fit result. This method was used to examine the interaction of various drugs with HSA. The dissociation rate constant that were obtained were found to have a good agreement with literature values. In the same method, at high injection flow rate, drug protein dissociation will be minimized and the measured free fraction can be used to determine the binding constant for the drug protein interaction as illustrated by the equation shown here. The results, again, give a good agreement with literature values. This work indicates that the ultrafast affinity extraction can simultaneously determine the free fraction, binding constant, and rate constant for drug-protein interactions. We then tried to use the ultrafast affinity extraction to study some other samples. For example, in some drug samples, there are more than one drug or more than one form of a drug present. The previously introduced method has some limitations in this type of studies, since all the free drug fraction will be extracted in one fraction at an ultrafast flow rate. To look at the interaction of each component with a protein in more details, we developed a multidimensional HPLC system to simultaneously examine the binding bedrock enantiomers to a protein. This work can help us better understand the protein interactions and therapeutic activities of each enantiomer. In this case, the free fraction of racemic warfarin was first extracted by a small affinity column, and the extracted fraction was then delivered to a second column for chiral separation. In this experiment, we injected the sample containing warfarin in the presence or absence of HSA onto this multidimensional system. Again, for the drug-protein mixture, we obtained a non-retained peak and followed by a retained peak. However, only a single peak was obtained for the sample containing racemic warfarin alone. About 18 seconds later after the sample injection, a valve in the system was switched to place the second column online, and the free fraction of the warfarin enantiomers was delivered to this column for chiral separation. The free fraction of R warfarin was determined by dividing this peak area to this peak area. The free fraction for S warfarin can also be determined as well. This method was found to be able to study the free drug fraction in serum samples. The free fraction of each enantiomer can also be used to estimate the binding constant for each enantiomer with HSA. Here are the obtained K values. The obtained values are comparable with the results from ultrafiltration and closed to the literature values. A similar system has been used to study the effects of protein modification on drug-protein interactions. Drugs used to treat type 2 diabetes and HSA were used as models. Diabetes is related to insulin deficiency or resistance to insulin that further cause high glucose level in the blood. It was found that the elevated level of glucose in diabetes can result in non-enzymatic glycation of proteins such as HSA and possibly alter the binding of this protein to the drug. The multidimensional system was used to study the effect of protein modification on HSA. The first column was used to extract the free drug fraction, and the second column was used for the further isolation and measurement of this fraction. Sulfonylurea drug, which is a group of drug commonly used to treat type 2 diabetes, was studied in this work. Each drug was incubated with normal HSA or HSA that has been glycated by glucose at various levels as are produced during diabetes. The free drug fraction were measured for drug protein samples prepared at physiological or therapeutic concentrations. These free drug fractions were used to indicate the effect of protein modification on the drug protein binding. It was found that the level of this glycation and the type of drug that was being examined both can affect the resulting free drug fraction. The binding constants for these drugs with normal HSA or glycated HSA were also determined. The results showed a good agreement with those predicted from previous binding studies. We were then thinking, can this method be used to study some other biological interactions, such as hormone-protein interactions? So we used testosterone as a hormone model. This hormone is a steroid hormone that has a concentration in a range of 10 to 42 nanomolar in adult males. It can mainly bind to two serum transport proteins in blood, which are human serum albumin and sex hormone-binding globulin. This results in only about 2% of testosterone is present in its free form in serum. The free form of testosterone is generally believed to be the biologically active form. However, some studies have shown that its protein-bound form, especially its complex with HSA, may also be available in tissue uptake. This makes it become important to have information regarding the interaction of testosterone with both of the binding proteins HSA or SHBG and the resulting free fraction and protein-bound fraction of this hormone in blood. The overall binding and rates of these interactions have also been of particular interest. Two proteins that both mainly bind to testosterone in serum were used as protein models in this work. Human serum albumin, as introduced earlier, is the most abundant transport protein in blood. It binds to testosterone at low to moderate affinity, about 10 to the 4th per molar. Sex hormone binding globulin, or SHBG, is another protein that can form a complex with testosterone. The physiological level of this protein is very low, but it shows strong binding to testosterone, about 10 to the 9th per molar. So in the bloodstream, testosterone mainly binds to SHBG. However, due to the large concentration of HSA present in the serum, half of the testosterone can also form a complex with HSA. So what's the resulting free fraction of testosterone if both HSA and SHBG are present in the sample at physiological level? In this study, we tried to prepare the samples that contain these components at different physiological levels and found by using with the multidimensional HPLC system, the ultrafast affinity extraction can be used to measure the resulting free hormone fraction. We were then thinking if this data can be used to determine the binding constants of testosterone with both HSA and SHBG. We first used these equations to describe the equilibrium between testosterone and HSA or SHBG. These equations can solve for the concentration of the complex that is formed after equilibrium is reached. These values were then substituted into these two equations to estimate the values of KA-SHBG and KA-HSA. These are the results we got from the free fraction values as shown in previous slides. Here is their average, and it fell within the range of the literature values. In summary, we developed a new approach based on ultrafast affinity extraction and HPSC to simultaneously determine both the rate constant and equilibrium constant for solute protein interactions. The obtained results were found in a good agreement with literature values. This method was also used with multidimensional HPLC methods to measure the free fractions of drug enantiomers and their binding constants with HSA. A similar method was then used to study the effect of protein glycation on binding by HSA to diabetes drugs. This developed method can be used to study the samples at clinically relevant concentrations or samples prepared in human serum or containing more than one binding protein. Advantages of this approach include its ability to be used as a label-free method and to directly examine interactions in solution. Other potential advantages were the speed of this method, its ease of automation, and its ability to be used with small amount of sample. I would like to thank many people who have provided me with great help throughout my graduate studies and in this presentation. I would like to acknowledge my advisor, Dr. Hage, for his mentorship and countless help in my research. Thank the member of H Group. Special thanks to Ryan, Maria, Penny, and Zhao for their help in my research projects. I also would like to thank UNL Chemistry Department, EBF, and special thanks to Future Science, Bioanalysis Zone, and Waters for honoring me with this award and for providing me this opportunity to present my work in this webinar. At last, I appreciate the NIH, NSF, F-Score, and CNFM for the funding. Thank you for listening.
If you have any questions on today's webinar, please send them to webinars@bioanalysis-zone.com. Thank you very much, Emmy, for that insightful presentation, and thank you all for listening. Look out for a recording of today's event on www.bioanalysis-zone.com/webinars, as well as other webinars by Bioanalysis Zone. Information on the Young Investigator Award, the profiles of all nominees, and how to enter the 2016 award can be found at the address shown on your screen now. Thanks again for listening today. Bye for now.